all, I just want to start by recognizing the fact that already stated we have lost a number of prominent people, starting with my Mabofa and Comrade Rutani. They are all major players in the agriculture sector. And now also last night, Liam Center. These were major, major players in the agriculture sector. So I also want to recognize that. Others have seen me also going up and down. I'm also acting in the place of the Minister of Home Affairs. So I hope you do appreciate the fact that I've been going up and down. So just also to look after things from that point of view. But however, for the purposes of our gathering this morning, already Honorable Smanda stood in for the Vice President, Comrade Mnangagwa, who is the Chair of the Food Security and Nutrition, in terms of reading the speech. Earlier on, my own Deputy Minister, Marapira, was also standing in for me. So I just want to recognize that. I want to recognize the Master of Ceremony, Ken Okatsandi. I want to recognize Honorable Chikuba, the Resident Minister, Harare Metropolitan Province. I also want to recognize Honorable Spanda, in his own right as Minister of State in the Vice President's office. The Deputy Minister I've already mentioned. I also want to recognize, we have Honorable Chitindi here. Others might not know, he's our chair from Parliament, the Parliamentary Portfolio Committee on Agriculture, Land and Water. I want to recognize you. Deputy Chief Secretary, Mpamanga, the Master of Ceremony, I've already recognized. We have Deputy Chief Secretary, Mpamanga. He chairs the Commander Agriculture Technical Committee. So I recognize you in that capacity as well. Dr. Mbawose, the NECF National Core Chair, I recognize you. Then Mr. Ngoni Kudenga, the Chair of the ZAS, the President of ZAS. We are in the week of the Agriculture Show. We are very grateful to you and your team, Dr. Masula. This is the week of the Agriculture Show. Want to thank you very much as the, I think for those who have had the preview, the stands are looking very, very good. I came on Saturday when it was all dusty and with lorries delivering things. But so far, I think it's looking very good. Thank you very much for that. I want to recognize the permanent secretaries, starting with PEMSEC Mabiza, the Minister of Justice. She also is in the Vice President's office, along with the staff in the Vice President, and others there. My own PEMSEC, Engineer Chitsiko. We also have the PEMSEC of the Minister of Lands, this year, Ambassador there. But I must also recognize in a special way there, the Chair of the Land Commission is here, and the commissioners that are here. I want to recognize you. must say, I must also recognize Dr. Pill, Your Excellency, the FAO regional representative, which I know he will be speaking later on, but I must express my gratitude for the work that we are doing together. Quite a lot of assistance, UNDP, FAO. Let me now just say all protocol observed. I want to recognize all industry in the manner that they are captains of industry, they are heads of parastatals that are here. I see COTCO is there in a strong way, so I recognize. And all government departments, also the office of the president and chief secretary and cabinet. I do recognize everybody. I want to recognize also the presenters. My remarks, because already we have received the speech from the guest of honor, it's really to appreciate just ahead of the photo of things. There are some remarks that I will just make to buttress the interest of business. Because this is a business forum, I would have done that ahead of the Vice President if he was here. So I simply want to buttress the business points that must be taken note of. The first one is the full recognition that there are two programs that are supporting the agriculture sector in terms of the capacity of the farmer to produce. Number one is the Presidential Input Scheme. That program, as you will see as we unfold the season, has many components and facets that is addressing the generality of the farmers in the main, the communal, the old resettlement, the small scale farmers, which we refer to as Matenganyika or the purchase areas, and A1. The second program, not the key program, anchoring in the main, the A2 farmers, and in some cases consolidated A1 or communal. As we look at maize production, the smallholder farmers can consolidate their land to reach the minimum 40 hectares. Then they are supported under command. The presidential input schemes are purely facilitating the capacity of the smallholder farmers. Those farmers do not pay back whatever they are assisted with. Command agriculture or special programs are very specific. The farmer is not receiving the inputs for free. Just to buttress that aspect. And this is why in the statutory instruments that have been referred to, there are criminal activities that we will deal with if farmers kind of abuse the inputs. These resources, I'm not saying the presidential input is not an investment, it is also an investment. But the spirit must be that we must use the inputs that would have been given and we must return what we would have been given. The third aspect might be contract farming, which we are supported by various companies. But as we all know, His Excellency the President has already pointed out that those who go in to contract farmers, we do not want those that are coming in through the back to then seize our land. We have to be very, very careful with that. So I just want to re-emphasize that in the future, as we move, and as always been, you must have the necessary authority from the Minister of Lands, Minister of Agriculture, to be a contracting party. You cannot just go on your own and start contracting farmers. In the interest of land reform, agrarian reform, we will have to buttress that position. And I'm assuming that also that aspect will be taken also by the Land Commission, that the land was given to our people for the purposes of deriving an agriculture activity, either for your own food security, but also for the cash economy. So we will be very strict on that. As already directed by the head of state, we cannot compromise the gains of the land and the agrarian reform. I just thought I emphasize that that point. We accept players to come in, but players who come in must come in on that clear authority that you cannot just come and do what you want. Shortchange farmers, shortchange us, or displace the people who we have benefited from the land reform. The second aspect that I just want to emphasize, because the business interest here must know what we are going to do. We are already in the season. There are various institutions, the banking sector, there are also chairpersons of chairmen of the various boards are also here. The presidential input scheme is going to support 1.8 million households with maize and small grains inputs. As we are talking, the inputs are already in the various depots across the country. This program this year will strictly be run by Agritex and the Grain Marketing Board. I just want the public to know that. It's not dealing with the farmers that last year were depressed as a result of the drought. The farmers in the main have recovered. So we are taking those farmers now as normal. There will be the traditional vulnerable households that will still be assisted. But in the main, the 1.8 million households will be strictly treated under the presidential input scheme relating to maize, small grains, as farmers. The second crop under the presidential input will be cotton. And the cotton will be strictly 400,000 households, 1 hectare each household. And we will be monitoring this. The inputs must go to those areas that traditionally produce cotton. And it will be managed by cotton company. Soon we will be establishing the Cotton Marketing Board. And the Cotton Marketing Board is not to be confused with the Cotton Company of Zimbabwe. These two will be operating. There will be several other marketing boards that are going to be re-established, i.e. the Dairy Marketing Board, the Cotton Marketing Board, and the Cold Storage Commission. Those are going to be restarted. And they have nothing to do with the current companies. The current companies will also who also operate that are 100% by government. So that is that on cotton. A very disturbing feature under the presidential input scheme is cotton that is being facilitated to be sold outside the country. That is illegal from a law enforcement point of view. And we are going to look into that. Because if a company is facilitating cotton to be sold across our borders, that is illegal. So we are going to put the necessary instruments to deal with that. It might even include invoking the Minister of Agriculture myself to control cotton. Don't be surprised if that happens. Because we cannot afford, as a state, to have this way of behavior. So it's both on the agriculture sector itself, the farmer unions themselves must also talk to their members. But we are obligated, together with the law enforcement agencies, to nip this practice in the bud, particularly in the sub-region, in the SADC region. We do not want a behavior like that. All crops, livestock must be accountable to their own territory, except where we have got agreements of the transfrontier, parks and so on. But when it comes to crops, because certainly we will undermine the financing structures, will undermine the resuscitation of industry. In actual fact, any company that will be doing that is facilitating, it's actually sabotaging the country. So we take that matter seriously. It has happened in other sub-region of Africa, that commodities are traded across the country without the proper accounting. We are battling sanctions as a country. So we need to account for every amount in terms of foreign currency earning, in terms of the industrial support, and in terms of whatever economic activity that we are entitled to as a sovereign state, that must be done properly. So I work on the basis, first of all, on an appeal, basis that we should not do that. As farmers, don't be tempted because there is no cash. Yes, it's understood. And I'm very happy to announce that as far as cotton is concerned, the central bank, Minister of Finance, we have agreed that we will give the cotton farmers some cash. But we will not leave the companies that might be facilitating that unpunished. That we cannot accept. Otherwise, we have anarchy if this is the behavior. The third crop that will be supported under the presidential input scheme will be soybean. Now, I will come to the command soybean crop. These are two separate crops. The presidential input scheme soybean crop, we are taking it in the main from an industrial point of view. But as agriculture, the argument that I did put was that the pulses or the nitrogen-fixing crops help us in the burden of the shortage of nitrogen. So from a crop husbandry point of view and the crop rotation, that is the first point that we are using soybean for. But it is one of the greatest values in terms of industry and the byproducts. So there are companies here, maybe one, but otherwise, rhizobium is produced by government itself at our Marondera plant. But there could be others who might be interested taking into security the matters.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.